My name is Manuel Mayr. I'm a British Heart Foundation Senior Research Fellow at King's College London, and my group works on cardiovascular proteomics. So my group has published a paper in the Journal of Clinical Investigation where we used a technology called proteomics to screen for extracellular proteins that are different between symptomatic and asymptomatic atherosclerotic lesions. The purpose of our study was to identify a molecular signature that discriminates atherosclerotic plaques from symptomatic and asymptomatic patients. The reason why this is important is because the first manifestation of cardiovascular disease often is a heart attack or a stroke. Ideally, we want to identify biomarkers that can predict who is likely to get these events. And we thought that the best way to identify those biomarkers would to look directly in the diseased tissue. So we used a technology called proteomics that allows us to identify proteins without the need for binders. We used this discovery approach to identify, on one hand, known biomarkers, on the other hand, unknown new biomarkers. And we found that the combination of the known and the new biomarkers together provide a new molecular signature that we can measure in blood to predict cardiovascular disease.
This is an example of a protein co-expression network in human carotid plaques. Matrix meloproteinase 9, MMP9, a known mediator in symptomatic plaques, was identified. In addition to this known biomarker, novel candidates were connected with MMP9 within the protein co-expression network. FN1, fibronectin, a known substrate of MMP9, S100A8/A9, two alarmins which form a complex called calprotectin, LGAL-S3-BP, galectin-3 binding protein, and CHI-3L1, chitinase-3-like protein 1. Our proteomics findings were validated at the transcript level in the BiKE cohort. The BiKE cohort is a biobank of human carotid plaques at the Karolinska Institute in Sweden. In addition, further validation was performed by another proteomics analysis of the secretome of human aortic smooth muscle cells. Upon lipid loading, galectin-3 binding protein was among the most upregulated proteins in the conditioned medium. The biomarker candidates identified by the tissue and cell-based proteomics approach were then measured in plasma samples. The samples we used were from the Brunek study, a longitudinal community-based study on cardiovascular disease with 10-year follow-up. The baseline levels of our biomarker candidates were all associated with advanced atherogenesis, whereas no or only weak associations existed with early atherosclerosis. All these proteins emerged as predictive for cardiovascular events over the 10-year follow-up. And these associations remain significant upon adjustment for standard cardiovascular risk factors, as well as high sensitivity C-reactive protein, another inflammatory protein.
So we used a method called mass spectrometry. Mass spectrometry allows us to measure proteins directly, and we compared the protein levels in symptomatic and asymptomatic atherosclerotic lesions. The beauty of this technology is that we do not need specific binders. We can compare the protein levels directly by using the same analytical platform. The traditional approach to do proteomics is on cell homogenates or tissue homogenates. What we did differently is that we subfractionate the tissue by decellularizing the tissues before we do the proteomic analysis. What this allows us to do is to separate the cellular components from the extracellular components. The first conclusion was that the tissue proteomic approach was very powerful in terms of revealing novel biomarker candidates. Usually we try to identify biomarkers in plasma and then associate them with protein expression changes in the tissue. We did it the other way around. We identified the biomarkers in the diseased tissue first and then showed that they also have predictive ability when they are measured in the circulation. The second conclusion is that for the first time we characterized at the proteomic level the inflammatory signature in human atherosclerotic lesions. And this is a more comprehensive analysis compared to the analysis that were done previously. And it allowed us to have an inflammatory signature that can be measured in the diseased tissue as well as in plasma samples. And the potential of this signature will have to be replicated in future cohorts. But ideally, we would like to have a biomarker panel that can predict cardiovascular disease before it manifests itself.